Welcome to our exploration of code testing with JavaScript. For this video, you're going to need a Visual Studio Code plugin called CodiumAI. CodiumAI uses artificial intelligence to analyze code, create tests, and find potential bugs before your code goes into production. You can access this plugin by searching the extensions for CodiumAI and then clicking Install from the CodiumAI description page. Now's a good time to pause the video and install CodiumAI. Don't worry, I'll wait for you. Okay, so now you've got the plugin, and before we dive into the technical details, let's first ask an important question. Why should we test our code? Testing is all about assurance, assuring that our code does what it's supposed to do and that it does it well. Testing gives us confidence in our code's behavior, validating that our functions return the expected results, that our components render correctly, and that our application's performance meets standard. Without testing, bugs can creep into production undetected, causing issues for users and potentially leading to lost revenue and a damaged reputation. Conversely, testing enables us to catch and fix bugs before they reach the end user, providing for a smoother and better user experience overall. But testing isn't about just bug hunting. It also promotes better software design and architecture. By encouraging us to write testable code, it indirectly leads us to create more modular, maintainable, and understandable software. So in a nutshell, testing helps us deliver reliable, robust, and high-quality code. It's an essential practice for every developer and plays a critical role in the software development lifecycle. Now, we're going to take a look at some different types of testing and how to apply them. Let's dive into a specific type of testing, unit testing. But what's a unit? In JavaScript, a unit could be a function, a module, or an object. Essentially, it's the smallest testable part of software. By isolating these units, we can test them in a controlled environment separate from the rest of the code base. This isolation makes it easier to identify and fix bugs. It's like shining a spotlight on a single actor on a stage. It's much easier to observe their performance when they're not obscured by the rest of the cast. Unit testing also helps us build software in a bottom-up manner. By ensuring that our individual units work as expected, we could combine them to form complex functioning software with greater confidence. It's like building a house brick by brick, assuring the quality of each brick before we put it into place. In a nutshell, unit testing is our first line of defense against bugs. It's a practice that promotes the early detection and resolution of issues, making our software more robust and reliable. Now, let's take a look at manual testing for JavaScript. Let's start with this simple JavaScript function that we want to test manually. This function obviously adds two numbers together that are passed into the function as parameters. For this particular test, I'm going to use the JavaScript console within my browser. Notice I've created several test cases. The first test case is two integers. Then we have a negative number, a zero, larger numbers, and also floating point numbers. The point here is I'm testing a number of different cases to make sure that my function still works. With each of these, I should have an expected output. Now I can run the tests manually. For each call to the function, I'm verifying that the output matches my expectations. It's a form of manual testing. I'm directly checking the results of the function calls. As you can imagine, this approach becomes unwieldy as our code base grows and is more complex. Automated testing, on the other hand, allows us to write tests that can be executed repeatedly without manual intervention, making it more efficient, especially for larger and more complex code bases. One step towards automated testing would be to use a function for the testing itself. Here I've created an assert function. The assert function has passed into it an expected result, an actual result, and a message. Now I can implement the assert function by asserting the various test cases and providing messages based on the success or failure. Here I've created a short HTML script so we can run tests.js. And now you can see the result of our initial manual tests. it looks like we got all our expected outputs. 3, 1, 2, 2, 10, and then we got 3.300003. And that's because of a limitation in JavaScript and the way it handles floating point numbers. Note that that's also going to cause our automated test to fail. Now we can see the results of our assert statements. Add numbers should add 2 positive numbers, success. Add numbers with 1 negative number, success. Add 2 larger numbers, success. But when we get down to the floating point number, we fail because our expected result was 3.3. So here, if we needed our function to work for all of these cases, we would have to deal with the limitation in how JavaScript deals with floating point numbers. If we introduce an error into one of the other test cases, for example, let's assert here that the result should be 0, we save. Now you can see that the corresponding test failed because it expected 0, but got 2. Now that you understand the importance of testing and we've looked at unit testing and an example of manual testing, let's look at some of the tools that are available to you for testing in JavaScript. JavaScript has a robust ecosystem of testing tools and libraries. Let's take a look at some of them. First, let's look at Jasmine. Jasmine is a behavior-driven development framework for testing JavaScript code. It's completely independent of any other JavaScript frameworks. It doesn't even require a DOM. So it's really versatile and easy to implement. It's great for beginners and has a nice, straightforward syntax. Next up is Mocha, another popular choice. Mocha is a feature-rich JavaScript test framework that makes asynchronous testing simpler and, they say, more fun. It provides developers with the flexibility to use an assertion library and allows for tests to be run serially, ensuring flexible and accurate reporting. Next, we have Jest, a testing framework developed by Facebook. Jest is widely popular because of its zero configuration promise, meaning it works right out of the box. It's known for its powerful mocking library and its snapshot feature that can capture the state of your UI to review changes over time. And the last choice I'm going to discuss is Cypress. Unlike the previous frameworks, Cypress is all about end-to-end testing. It allows you to set up tests directly in your browser, simulating the experience a real user would have. It's especially useful for testing complex user interactions in a real-world context. If you're new to JavaScript testing, I suggest you begin with an easy-to-use framework, like Jasmine, then work your way to more complex frameworks later. Next up, we've got something exciting. We're going to be taking a look at CodiumAI, an artificial intelligence-based testing tool. So here I am in the Visual Studio Code environment, and I've added 2 functions to tests.js. The first function, area of a rectangle, calculates the area of a rectangle. It takes length and height as parameters, and then does the math. Second function calculates a batting average, given at-bats, walks, and hits. I know this is a slightly simplified version of the batting average calculation. You'll notice that above each function is a test this function option. Let's click test this function over area of rectangle to activate CodiumAI. Codium loads, and we get 3 separate tabs, a code analysis tab, a code suggestions tab, and a test suite. You'll notice that these are being populated as we go. Let's start with the code analysis. This analyzes the code and lets us know what it thinks the code is supposed to do. So here, CodiumAI has determined that the main objective of the function is to calculate the area of the rectangle based on length and height. It notes that we have a length and height input and defines those. It provides a 4-step function flow, starting with the function taking in the length and height as inputs, and a final step of the flow returning the value of area. It defines the output, which is the area, the calculated area of the rectangle, and notes some additional aspects. There are 5 suggestions to improve the code. Let's look at a couple of these. The first is the function should check if the input parameters are numbers. So of course this is correct. JavaScript is not a strongly typed language. So we could actually send strings or inappropriate types of values to this function, causing an error. In addition to the suggestion, Codium tells us why the suggestion is important. And in this case, it's important to ensure that the input parameters are correct to avoid unexpected behavior or errors. It then gives us suggested code that we can use to implement the suggestion. I'm simply going to copy that code from the suggestion into the function itself. The code that was generated by CodiumAI checks to make sure the type of length and the type of height is both number. If it's not, then we throw an error, input parameters must be numbers. Let's check that suggestion off and move on to the next one. The function should check if the input parameters are positive numbers. Well, of course, you can only calculate an area with positive values for length and height. Let's take this suggestion as well. So now we're checking if the length or the height are below zero. We'll throw a different error, which simply says length and height must be positive numbers. The next suggestion is pretty similar to the first one, so I'm not going to implement that. There's another suggestion that the function should be part of a class or a module which groups similar functions, like geometry utilities. That makes sense. And the final suggestion is about performance. The function could return the result without directly storing it in a variable. And then it tells you why. Storing the result in a variable is unnecessary and takes up memory. Directly returning the result improves performance and reduces memory usage. In this case, realistically, it doesn't make a huge difference, but we can implement the suggestion anyway. So instead of storing area, let's just return length times height. Check that suggestion off because it's implemented as well. As we move to the test suite tab, there's a lot here to look at. First off, a number of tests have been generated by Codium AI that we can run. Let's take a look at the first test. This tests that the function returns the correct area when given positive integer values for both length and height. I'm going to run that test by clicking the run button. It takes just a moment, and we've passed that test. Let's look at the second test. This tests that the function returns the correct area when given a decimal value for length and height. Let's run. And we've passed that test. Should we do one more? This tests that the function throws an error when given a length and height as zero. And this passes the test thanks to the code suggestions that were made in the other panel. Let's try one more. This tests that the function throws an error when given length as a negative. Excellent. And there's some additional tests as well. Let's just take a look at a couple of additional things in the test suite. First off, the configuration. I can actually choose from several testing frameworks. Jest, Mocha, and Jasmine, which I mentioned before, are all part of the testing libraries that you can use. I can set up a number of tests. I can regenerate the tests that have been generated. I can also look at the behaviors covered. Here we've covered testing with positive integers for length and height, testing with decimal values, and then a number of edge cases, like testing for length and height is zero, or testing with a negative value. I can generate some additional tests from here as well. Let's test what happens if height is delivered as a string. I'm going to generate the test. Let's close the behaviors panel. And if I scroll down to the bottom, you can see the new test. Let's run. And we've passed this test as well. We can try and modify the tests with ChatGPT. Modify the test so a negative integer is given for length and a positive integer for height. So now it used the ChatGPT API and it's modified the test. And you can see here in the code that we now have a negative value and a positive value. We can run this test and it's passed the modified version of the test. I think the CodiumAI extension gives us a glimpse into the future. It's like having a senior developer look over our shoulder and make suggestions. And the tests are extremely helpful to make sure we're writing bulletproof code. I do hope you enjoyed this video, this introduction to testing in JavaScript, and this look to the future with CodiumAI. I'm Mark. Thanks so much for watching.